Hello, my name is Sally Caselli. In this comprehensive tutorial, we'll go over some of the basic stuff to start with and then understand some of the concepts and features of Microsoft Word 2016. Please hang along here throughout the whole tutorial and view as many of the modules as you can. This is designed so it can enhance your resume and understand how to use the latest version of Microsoft Word effectively for your job and in your career. We are going to cover some of the basic features, such as getting started using the templates, understanding the Office ribbon concepts and what's new there, formatting the documents, applying styles to text, and then customizing existing format styles, creating a custom style, and using a format painter, using search and replace, then enhancing your document by inserting pictures, shapes, smart art, tables, charts, screenshots, online video in a document, hyperlinks, comments, headers and footers. Then we move into inserting page numbers, text boxes, and the files from another document, a cover page, a page break, and then how to enhance the document, such as applying themes to the whole document, and also how to change the formatting of the document by changing the margins and changing the orientation, columns in the document, formatting the paragraph, and then using references for your document, such as table of content, creating citations and bibliography, and then also doing mail merges, such as for labels, envelopes, and email merges as well. Finally, as a progression here, let's suppose that you have a big document or a big project to complete, check the grammar, finally check some of the research tools, insert comments, and then inspect the document before sharing it with other users. So stick around and check out as many of those modules as you can. And now we'll get started in a moment here with the first module for Microsoft Word 2016. In this session, I'm going to cover the most basic concepts in getting started with Word 2016. So we open Microsoft Word. You can either click here on the Word icon, or if you cannot locate it, you can simply type here Microsoft Word or just Word and then choose Word 2016. Now this is new with newer versions of Word, particularly 2013 and 16 here, but notice you're presented here with a bunch of templates, so you can start a blank document. You can take a tour of Microsoft Word, or you can use one of those pre-designed templates that you are presented with. These are presented to you in the very beginning so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Now notice here on the left-hand side, you also have the recent documents that you have been working with, and also you have the option here to open other documents in your computer. So let's assume that you wanted to use one of those templates. Instead of you redesigning something, you can simply click on one of those designs or templates and click to create it, and it's as simple as that, and then all you have to do is fill in this information in any of these fields. Let's go back to the previous window here. Notice that you can also search for templates online. So let's say I want brochure. Type what you want, and then you'll see here a listing of designs from the web. All you have to do, like we did earlier, you can click on it and then it'll open up and change it. Notice you also have these options here on the right-hand side, so feel free to check those out as well. Open it, now click on create. Notice it has all the components and you do not have to reinvent the wheel. So the third scenario here is how to create a new document. So of course, let's assume that we don't need these whatsoever and we are starting from scratch. You'll find the Microsoft Word and you'll click on a blank document. Once you click on a blank document, now you're presented with the interface for Microsoft Word. So before we get any further here, I'll just take a couple more minutes and explain just some of the components that exist here in Word 2016. It's very similar to the previous versions that you're used to using. However, it probably helps for somebody who is starting. So notice here, you have these different tabs here on the very top. You have the Home tab, the Insert tab, You have the design tab, the layout tab, and so on. The tabs here, along with all of these different icons within each one of the tabs, and those icons are simply different functions that you can perform in a document using Microsoft Word. Notice that those functions are also grouped together. So for example, all the stuff that has to do with the fonts, it's under the font block here, or grouping. Anything that has to do with paragraphs or styles, it's under the paragraph grouping here, or styles grouping. If you go under the Insert tab, similar thing as well. You have here anything that has to do with illustrations, it's in the, it's its own grouping, and so on. So the way those tabs work, they are organized in the order that you'd most likely work with in a document. So particularly if you're working on a brand new document, you're going to create the content, format the text, paragraphs, apply some styles, then you're going to insert stuff to the document, such as pictures and tables and such, and then you're going to change the layout to the document, you're going to add some references, potentially you might be doing some mailings and so on, and then finally you might be doing some review for it, checking spelling and such. And then under the View tab here, you'd be able to read it to finalize before you send that document or project to somebody. So again, the concept to understand here is that they are organized in a certain way, grouped, the icons are grouped together, and the tabs are in a specific order depending on the work that you are doing. Notice also you have the File menu. This is back from, if you remember, in Office 2007, that was taken away. Notice you have some additional options here, how to save the document, how to print it, share it, export it, and so on. Notice if you wanted to change also options within your application, you'd go under Options here, and this is where you can customize additional settings related to Microsoft Word in your computer. Now you could change here, for example, the themes, or you could change the display, and but one of the things that you might want to change and might end up changing at some point is this save location as well. So just check those out, and nothing is going to be broken as long as you potentially take note of what you're changing. Now here on the very top left, you have what's called a quick access toolbar. The quick access toolbar has the most commonly used functions here, and you can customize this to add additional items as well. So notice I clicked here on the drop down, you can put here the email icon or attach icon. Now if you wanted also an icon here, let's say for inserting pictures, well, all you have to do is you right click here and choose to add it to quick access toolbar, and now the option to add pictures, it's added to the quick access toolbar. So again, quick access toolbar, it serves for you to get quickly to whatever you need to do. Another thing to remember here is that notice we don't see the ruler anywhere in this document. So this is an area, of course, where you type your document and such. So if you need to view additional components here, you can choose to, under the View tab, you want to customize to show the ruler for the document. You can even have grid lines if you needed to, and navigation pane as well if you need it to. Additionally, before I finalize this quick session here, notice that on the bottom right here, you have also options for zooming in and out of the document, and you have the various different layouts for this specific document, whether you want to do a read mode or the print layout mode. Here on the left, you also have the page numbers and the words in this specific document. If you click on any of these options here, it will give you more information about your document. Finally, one quick feature, and this is new in Word 2016, is that let's say you're on the Home tab here and you don't know how to do something. Well, Office 2016 has this option here that you can, it says, tell me what you want to do. So if you wanted to change, let's say, the margins, you simply type margins here. And notice it gives you all the potential options here, so you don't necessarily have to know where an option is, even though I'm going to explain it in this tutorial. So you click here on Adjust Margins, and it gives you all the different options for margins, even though you're not in that specific tab. If you're not sure as to how to do something, you can also click here on Get Help on Margins, and it'll take you to the online help for Office 2016 directly from Microsoft. So some of those options, we'll learn them as well as we go, but I thought it would be helpful for you to know about this feature. Tell me what you want to do. So hopefully that is helpful. Stay tuned. We'll get started in a moment. The next segment here on getting started with a document, doing some of the basic functions in a document.